That is Republican Bob Turner celebrating a huge upset in a Democratic stronghold of New York City. He won the seat of Anthony Weiner, the disgraced lawmaker whose sexting scandal went public. Mary Snow is live for us in New York. So, Mary, is this a referendum on the Obama presidency?
Well, the Republicans certainly worked to make it so, Kira, but, you know, there had been polling done ahead of this election, and it showed that the economic recovery was the number one theme. The fact that Bob Turner, who is a former cable TV executive, has never been a politician before, although he's run in some other races, the fact that he could beat a Democrat in this district where the Democrat was really expected to win this race easily until the past few weeks, Democrats became increasingly nervous. This is a district where Democrats outnumber Republicans 3-1. It's not as liberal as many people might think. There are a lot of conservative Democrats, that is, and the Republican candidate here seized on their frustrations.
We've been asked by the people of this district to send a message to Washington, and I hope they hear it loud and clear. Yeah! We have been told this is a referendum, and we're ready to say, Mr. President, we are on the wrong track.
You know, Kira, the Democrat in this race, David Weprin, tried to make the protection of Social Security and Medicare an issue in this race. It was one that helped a Democrat win in a special election last spring in a Republican district, but he couldn't gain traction here.
All right, Mary. Well, this election wasn't all about local politics, right? I mean, Israel was a huge issue.
Yeah, and it was really unusual in a special election that it would play such a big part. And the Republican here, Bob Turner, a Roman Catholic, really accused David Weprin, the Democrat, who's an Orthodox Jew, of, you know, the question became, who is the stronger supporter of Israel? And the Republican went after President Obama, saying he wasn't supporting Israel enough. And he got some help from Ed Koch, a former New York City mayor who's a Democrat. He endorsed the Republican in this race over the issue of Israel and President Obama's policies on it.
Well, we're going to talk a lot about this, of course. Mary Snow out of New York for us. Thanks so much. And Turner's win in New York is not the only victory that Republicans are celebrating this week. They also won a special election to fill a House seat in Nevada. Deputy Political Director Paul Steinhauser in Washington. So, Paul, tell us about this race.
Yeah, you know, Kira, the Republicans went 2-for-2 last night in these special elections. The one in Nevada, this was a seat that's been held by Republicans for a long time in the central northern part of the state, and it was a seat that they once again held on to. A guy called Mark Amadei won the race, and he won it by more than 20 points, Kira. And this is the interesting part here. Listen, this is a state, Nevada, where Barack Obama won it last time around in the presidential election in 2008, a battleground state. It's also a state that he wants to win again, and it's a state where the Democrats think they have a shot at maybe winning back a Senate seat. So a 22-point victory by the Republican candidate is a little bit troubling, no doubt about it, for the Democrats. Now, Republican National Committee Chairman Reince Priebus, he had this to say about both the victories last night. This should be cause for concern for Democrats across the country. He goes on to say tonight's elections prove yet again that President Obama is failing America. Kira, listen. Both these elections, there were local issues. As Mary said, Israel and also gay marriage was a big deal back in the New York 9 race, and there were also local issues here. But Republicans were trying to make both these elections a referendum on Barack Obama, on the president, and it seems to a degree they were successful. But I will say this, special elections, Kira, take them with a grain of salt. The Democrats did very well in those special elections in 2009 and 2010, but they did very poorly in the 2010 midterm elections, Kira.
And you've got Massachusetts making news, too. Elizabeth Warren throwing her hat into the ring.
Yep, she made it official. We knew she was going to do it, but this morning, Elizabeth Warren, remember her, the former Obama administration official, consumer advocate, she was the person who headed up the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau for the White House, made it official, launched her bid in Massachusetts. She joins 7 other Democrats there now going for the Democratic nomination in the Senate. Who do they have their eyes on? Scott Brown, of course, the Republican senator there. Democrats think he's vulnerable. Remember, he had that huge upset back in January of last year, winning that seat that was once held by Ted Kennedy, a longtime Democratic seat. Democrats would like to knock Brown out next year. Stay tuned on that one, Kira.
Okay.